We told you last week about an increase in swarming bees due to the humid and wet weather. One area seeing a big increase in bees also sees hundreds of hikers a day. We're talking about the Koko Head Crater Trail on Oahu. After our story aired, more hikers shared their frustration with us, saying the bee problem has become worse, and they want to know why the city is not taking action. Officials told us last week they're looking for a solution. We wanted to know if it's an easy or hard fix. Brent Ramadan got some answers. Brent?
Joe, I reached out to a local beekeeper who is very familiar with the problem on Koko Head. He says he could remove the bees right away, but he doesn't have the approval to do it yet. Take a hike up the Koko Head Crater Trail and you'll probably come across bees.
How many honeybees are up there?
There's a hive right here.
And it's not just a few.
Look to be hundreds of them swarming, and I was praying to keep my balance and not be stung.
I'm already not too fond of heights, so seeing the bees didn't really help me going that way anyway, so.
I took the hikers' concerns to beekeeper Steve Montgomery, who agreed to hike the trail and take a look at the situation.
They've been here for months and months because I've been getting reports from hikers about bees up here and what could be done.
Now, as you can see here, the bees are right next to the trail, and many people have concerns, especially in this area where you have to go across a bridge.
So, and what's happened here is that the support beams for this old tramway have been attacked by termites and hollowed out, and a knothole has opened up a door for them.
You can see one of the entrances here, and on closer inspection, Montgomery stumbled upon something else.
There's a bee checking me out now because I just discovered, while we were talking, a second timber that has a second colony in it that's right below me.
In all, he found five separate colonies living inside the bridge, and he said he could remove them right away.
If I had a saw and authorization, I could.
Authorization he doesn't have yet and would need from the city. I reached out to the city again this week to see what's being done. In a statement, they told me they have received reports and are evaluating the best course of action to safely remove the bees. In the meantime, Montgomery says the city should put up markers to warn people of the dangers.
If they did step on the railroad tie, which is housing this colony, it's a natural defense for the guard bees to come out and see what's causing the problem.
Montgomery says he'd be able to remove the bees without harming them, something hikers say would be the best solution.
I think that'd be the best thing. You know, you don't hurt the bees and it makes it safer for people to travel up.
I also reached out to area councilman Trevor Ozawa. He tells me he will reach out to the city parks department to see what action can be taken. And if you come across a swarm of bees, you should never swat at them. Instead, remain calm and slowly walk away. We'll stay on top of this story and we'll let you know how the city handles the bee issue. Brent Ramadnik, KHON 2 News.